Hi, welcome to Enchiridion. This is a two-part video series on Troodon, and in the first section, which is this one, we will see a thorough description of Troodon, including its intelligence and history, a description of theropods, an introduction to morphometrics, early research related to Troodon, and the naming of related species of Troodon. In the second video, we will look at the dissolution of the Troodon 1 species model, Troodon's classification, paleobiology, and paleoecology, Troodon eggs, troodontids, and discuss questions such as what might have happened if Troodon survived the KT mass extinction 65 million years ago, what its name means, and multiple other interesting questions, as well as its appearances in popular culture. With that being said, let's begin this first video of the two-part series on Troodon. Initially known from a single tooth, and originally thought to be a lizard, Troodon has been one of the most complex dinosaurs to classify. To commence this investigation of Troodon, I'd like to introduce the fact that it had a very large brain for its size, suggesting that it may have been smarter than the average dinosaur, and even as intelligent as modern birds. Some call it the world's smartest dinosaur, and there is some truth to that. Allow me to explain. How do we know it was as intelligent as modern birds? Because its brain is larger than those found in living reptiles, so the animal may have been as intelligent as modern birds, which are more similar in brain size. According to one analysis, Troodon had a high encephalization quotient, meaning it was intelligent. Its encephalization quotient, or EQ, was 6 times higher than the dinosaur average. And how can we confirm it was intelligent? By estimating its intelligence by the size of its brain compared to its body. It was about as smart as a chicken. Despite their cover, chickens are smart because when placed in social situations requiring them to solve problems, they are able to make decisions on what is best for them, and they possess a simple form of empathy called emotional contagion, meaning they are smart, caring, and complex. They can delay gratification. They have a good memory, they understand object permanence, they can count, they have a personality, they are empathetic, and even manipulative. So one can only wonder how Troodon was in terms of its social behavior. Troodon, in a nutshell, was a small theropod dinosaur, estimated to be 6.5 feet to almost 10 feet long, 3 feet tall, and estimated to have weighed almost 90 to 110 pounds. Small theropods include Abimimus, Archaeopteryx, Bambiraptor, and Caudipteryx. Theropods include all flesh-eating dinosaurs and are the most diverse group of lizard-hipped or saurischian dinosaurs, ranging from the tiny Microraptor to the huge Tyrannosaurus rex. All theropods were obligate bipeds, meaning that their hind legs provided support while their forelimbs were used for grasping and tearing prey. Troodon had a mainly carnivorous diet and lived during the late Cretaceous around 76 to 65 million years ago. It was found in parts of the US and lived among the streams and deltas of coastal plains alongside other dinosaurs like Dromaeosaurus and Anoxaurus. Troodon is a dubious or unknown and doubtful creature, as well as a former wastebasket taxon, or a creature that doesn't fit elsewhere. Of small, bird-like dinosaurs from the Cretaceous period, about 77 million years ago, it includes at least one species, Trodon formosus, known from Montana in northwestern United States. It had long legs with specialized feet, in which the middle bone was pinched out at the top to form a shock-absorbing wedge. This allowed it to run with quite some speed. Troodon formosus was a small Coelurosaurian dinosaur of the same clade or evolutionary group as modern birds. Fossilized remains have been discovered of nesting parents and egg clutches. These finds help scientists understand the reproductive methods that are similar to both crocodilians and birds. It was discovered in October 1855, and interestingly, Troodon formosus was one of the first dinosaurs found in North America. Yet it was thought to be a lizard. At the time, expressing opposing views to this idea wasn't well received. to clear up the Troodon confusion, a 2017 study found that the well-known troodontid specimens from the Dinosaur Park Formation in Alberta found the genus to be undiagnostic and referred some of these specimens to the genus Stanonycosaurus, thought by many in the paleontological community to be synonymous with Troodon, and others were referred to the newly created genus Latinibenatrix. But there is still much work to be done in classifying this dinosaur. Troodon is Greek for wounding teeth, highlighting the teeth, which were different from those of other theropods known at the time of their discovery. Theropods are a dinosaur clade characterized by hollow bones and three-toed limbs, and were ancestrally carnivorous. Their teeth have prominent, apically oriented serrations. These wounding serrations are morphometrically more similar to those of herbivorous reptiles, suggesting a possibly omnivorous diet. It may have been an opportunistic omnivore, feeding on seeds, nuts, and fruits, as well as smaller mammals, dinosaurs, and birds. Its long claw suggests that it may have killed large prey, such as young duck-billed dinosaurs, as well as younger hadrosaur, ceratopsian, and pachycephalosaur species. It also had two large retractable sickle claws that were raised off the ground while it ran at speed. Morphometrics, or morphometry, for those who don't know, is the quantitative analysis of form encompassing size and shape. These analyses are useful in analyzing fossil records. Morphometrics can be used to quantify a trait of evolutionary significance, and by detecting changes in shape, deduce something of their ontogeny, which is the origination and development of an organism from egg fertilization to adult, or basically an organism's lifespan, function, or evolutionary relationships. It's quite interesting, actually. The name was originally spelled Troodon by Joseph Leidy in 1856, later changed by Sawbridge in 1876 to the current name, Troodon. This type specimen, or the organism to which the scientific name of the organism is formally attached to, has created problems regarding classification, as the entire genus is based only on a single tooth from the Judith River Formation. By the way, many cool remains have been discovered in this formation, including Leonardo, a rare intact mummified Brachylophosaurus canadensis. Historically, Troodon has been a highly unstable classification, and has been the subject of numerous conflicting synonyms with similar theropod specimens. The Troodon tooth was originally classified as a lizard by Leidy, but reassigned as a megalosaurid dinosaur by Nopska in 1901. In 1924, Gilmore suggested that the tooth belonged to the herbivorous pachycephalosaur, Stegoceras. The pachycephalosaur classification was followed for many years, during which the family of Pachycephalosauridae was known as Troodontidae. In 1945, Charles Mortram Sternberg, an American-Canadian fossil collector and paleontologist, rejected the possibility that Troodon was a pachycephalosaur due to its stronger similarity to the teeth of other carnivorous dinosaurs. With Troodon now classified as a theropod, the family Troodontidae could no longer be used for the dome-headed dinosaurs, so Sternberg named a new family for them, Pachycephalosauridae. The first specimens assigned to Troodon that weren't teeth were both found by Sternberg in the early 1930s, in the Dinosaur Park Formation of Alberta. The Dinosaur Park Formation is home to dense concentrations of dinosaur skeletons, often found with preserved remains of soft tissues. The first specimen was named Stanonycosaurus inequalis, based on a foot, fragments of a hand, and caudal vertebrae. A prominent feature of these remains was the enlarged claw on the second toe, which is now recognized as a characteristic of early parabians. Parabians are a group of theropod dinosaurs, including dromaeosaurids, troodontids, ancyronithids, and scansoriopterids. Sternberg initially classified Stanonycosaurus as a member of the family Coeluridae, a group of small, carnivorous dinosaurs from the late Jurassic period. The second, a partial lower jawbone, was described by Gilmore as a new species of lizard he named Paleontosaurus grandis. In 1951, Sternberg recognized Paleontosaurus grandis as a possible synonym of Troodon and speculated that because Stanonycosaurus had a very particular pes and Troodon equally unusual teeth, they may have been closely related. Current paleontological research by Bander, Riest, and Curry indicates that Paleontosaurus was determined to be a nomen dubium, not fit for synonymy with other taxa. In 1969, a more complete skeleton of Stanonycosaurus was described by American-Canadian geologist and paleontologist Dale Russell from the Dinosaur Park Formation. In the 1980s, Stanonycosaurus became a well-known theropod when the feet and brain case were described in greater detail. Along with Sauroornithoides, it formed the family Sauroornithoidae. Sauroornithoides is a troodontid maniraptoran dinosaur that lived during the late Cretaceous period and was a predator which could run fast on their hind legs and had excellent sight and hearing. Based on differences in tooth structure and the extremely fragmentary nature of the original Troodon formosus specimens, Sauroornithoidids were thought to be close relatives, while Troodon was considered a dubious possible relative of the family. Phil Curry, Canadian paleontologist and museum curator, while reviewing the pertinent specimens in 1987, demonstrated that supposed difference in tooth and jaw structure among troodontids and sauroornithoidids were based on age and position of the tooth in the jaw, as opposed to a difference in species. He reclassified Stanonycosaurus inequalis, as well as Paleontosaurus grandis and Pectinodon baccarai, as junior synonyms of Troodon formosus. He also made Sauroornithoidae a junior synonym of Troodontidae. Just a year later, Gregory S. Paul went farther and included Sauroornithoides mongoliensis in the genus Troodon as Troodon mongoliensis. Yet this reclassification wasn't adopted by other researchers. Nonetheless, Curry's classification of all North American troodontid material in the single species Troodon formosus became widely adopted by other paleontologists, and all of the specimens once called Stanonycosaurus were referred to as Troodon in the scientific literature through the early 21st century. This has been Enchiridion. Thank you for watching, and see you on next week's episode, where we will first look at the dissolution of the Troodon one species model. This is Enchiridion. See you next time.